Hey guys, ChrisFix here, and today I'm gonna show you how to get your car or truck ready for a snowstorm. We've had a ton of snow lately, and tomorrow we're supposed to get anywhere between 4 and 12 inches of snow. It's gonna be a storm overnight, and that gives me the opportunity to show you guys how I get my vehicles ready and show you the tips and tricks that I've learned over the years of living somewhere that gets a ton of snow. And I make it real simple and real easy so the next morning when you wake up, you're not scraping ice off your windshield, your battery's not dead, your door isn't frozen shut, you get in your car and you drive off and you're good to go. You won't be late for school, you won't be late for work, and you'll get to where you need to be nice and safe. So let's get started. Now the first thing I recommend you do is make sure you have a full tank of fuel. This is very important, so check your fuel gauge. And if we check the gauge, you can see I am low on fuel. I definitely want to fill this up now because tomorrow the gas stations might be closed. Also, if I go out tomorrow and I get stuck or get into an accident, I want to make sure I could run my vehicle without worrying about running out of gas, because if I could run my vehicle, I could stay warm. If I run out of gas, I could freeze and that wouldn't be good. And the last reason why it's important to fill up your fuel tank is because the fuel tank is typically in the rear of the vehicle, and that means all that fuel will be extra weight over the rear axle. Now, if you have a rear-wheel drive car or truck, that's especially important because that's how you're gonna get your traction. Actually, some people put metal and sandbags in the bed of their truck to get more traction, or you could put it in the trunk of your car to get more traction. But in this case, a simple thing such as filling up your fuel tank could add 100, 120 pounds. Every gallon of gasoline is about 6 pounds. So a 20-gallon tank, it's about 120 pounds of gasoline over that rear axle to get you some more traction. Something super simple that you could do really easily, you need to get fuel anyway, could help you a lot if it snows. So go fill her up. All right, after you're done filling your tank, the next tip is to always combat park your cars in your driveway or in your parking spot. All combat parking is backing into your spot. And I like to combat park my vehicles in general, but especially during snowstorms, so I'm backing in both my cars at the end of the driveway. And this is super helpful because tomorrow you won't have to back out. You could go straight out. And this helps a lot because if there's a snowplow guy coming around the block or if there's a car coming around the block, you'll see them. And more importantly, it's gonna be a snow day tomorrow. So if there's kids in the street and you don't see them backing out, that could be dangerous. Now we have the car facing this way. You'll clearly see if there's any kids in front of you, and it's a lot safer to leave your driveway that way. Also, when the snowplow guy comes around the block, he's gonna be pushing the snow up against your driveway, unfortunately, creating a big pile of snow. And it's a lot easier for your car or truck to go through that forward than if you were going in reverse. So back in your car, combat park it, and you'll be good to go. All right, so we have a full gas tank. We are combat parked. The next thing to do is to make sure that you have enough wiper fluid. So washer fluid is alcohol-based. You can see it says de-icer right on there. So it'll help remove any snow or ice that might get on your windshield. So make sure you're filling the wiper reservoir. And although it seems like common sense, many people don't think about topping off their wiper fluid until they run out. Okay, good. Now our wiper fluid is topped off. Now my next tip is very helpful for preventing your doors and locks from freezing. You ever try to go over to your door and put the key in and it won't turn or it won't go in because it's frozen solid? Or maybe you try to open your door and you're pulling on it and it's just frozen solid. You feel like you're gonna rip this handle off because the whole thing is frozen and won't open up. You can't even get into your car to warm it up. That way you can melt the ice. Well, the trick is to use a silicone spray like this. I'll link this in the description of my video so you can easily find it. What silicone does is it's hydrophobic, meaning it repels water, it displaces water. So water won't be able to freeze if it's not there. So what you do, just get a paper towel under here, get your spray inside that lock. Don't spray a lot. You just need a little bit like that and you are good to go. That displaces all the water that might be in there. That way it won't freeze. And if you want to be thorough, you could get your key and just work it in there like that, and that'll make sure all that water gets displaced and the silicone works its way in. So now we don't have to worry about the lock freezing shut, but how do we make sure that our door doesn't freeze shut? And it's actually pretty simple. So around the entire door is weather stripping. This prevents water from getting into the interior of the car, but it also holds water, not very much, but enough that when it freezes, it could freeze itself to the body of the car. There's also weather stripping right here that could also hold water and freeze and then freeze to the door. So to prevent water from sticking to the weather stripping, get a towel and spray it with silicone like that. And then you're gonna wipe the silicone onto the weather stripping, making sure you get complete coverage. It doesn't have to go on thick, just make sure you wipe down the entire piece of rubber. And the good thing is, after you do this, it will last all winter and you won't have to reapply. Also, don't forget to wipe down the weather stripping on the door itself. And be careful not to get any silicone on any of the interior trim. So with the weather stripping on the door and in the door jamb lightly coated with silicone, this is good to go and we don't have to worry about our door freezing shut. And one last quick thing to spray down with silicone that a lot of people forget about is the hood latch, or in this case, on this Jag, we have two hood latches, and you wanna just spray it down enough to displace any water. You don't have to go crazy. We have one there, and we have one here. And this is actually pretty important, because think about it. In the winter, a lot of times batteries go dead. You'll need to get a jump start. If you can't pop your hood because it's frozen shut, you won't be able to jump start your car and you won't be able to get your car running. That wouldn't be good. So a quick spray of silicone on your hood latch is all you need, and you're good to go. And real quick, I just wanna show you my truck's hood latch, because this is pretty common on most vehicles. The Jaguar's a little bit different. The hood latch is usually in the middle like that, and you could just spray it down like that. Nice and simple. That's all there is to it. And the last tip I have will prevent the glass from becoming a big sheet of ice. You won't have to scrape it in the morning. And the same thing with your side view mirrors. They won't become a block of ice. And it's actually really simple what you need to do. We'll start with the side view mirror, because I hate when these freeze. You can't use a scraper on a side view mirror because you'll damage that mirror. So the trick to prevent any ice from forming is to grab a Ziploc bag like this. And it's pretty simple. All you need to do is cover your side view mirror, get it all the way on there, and zip that bag tight. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna prevent any snow, any sleet, rain, anything that'll freeze onto here from actually getting on here. It works so well, it's so easy. So all you have to do is put one of these on each mirror. Now for the windshield, the first tip is to lift your windshield wipers so they don't freeze to the glass. And then I like to use a canvas windshield cover that's made specifically for keeping snow and ice off the glass. And as you can see, it covers the entire windshield. You could tuck this in underneath the wiper arms here and also here, so it looks a lot nicer and prevents the ice from getting in over there, like so. And then it has these straps that go right around the mirrors, and they're soft so they won't damage your paint, and that kind of holds it in place like that. And then now, any snow that falls on here, any ice that might freeze on here, it's easily removed just by removing this canvas piece. Now I get it, not everybody's gonna have one of these, or you might not wanna buy it. So in a pinch, you could use garbage bags to cover the windshield, like so. Since the windshield is large, I'm using two bags, and the trick is to make sure they lay flat against the glass so they cling tightly to it. So the garbage bags actually do a pretty good job at clinging to the glass, just with a static cling. Now, if it gets really windy, this isn't gonna hold in place the same that the canvas will, but if you put your windshield wipers down like that, it'll hold the bottom, and if you know it's gonna get windy, you could add a little bit of painter's tape to the top. One piece here, one piece in the middle, one piece on the other side. Painter's tape won't damage your car's paint, and it'll hold it in place, and you have something that actually works to prevent ice and snow from getting on your windshield. I can't wait to show you tomorrow how well these tips and tricks work. So now all we have to do is wait for some snow, and with a little bit of editing magic, oh man, and look at all this snow. This is way more than the forecast. But the good thing is, it gives me the opportunity to show you guys how to get all this snow off the car quickly, easily, without scratching the paint. And you did half the work already last night when you got the car ready for this snowstorm. So let's get started. First, we want to shovel the snow from the driveway. This snow is actually pretty heavy and starting to get icy, so it's a good thing we're getting this done now rather than later. And annoyingly, this snow is sticking to the shovel, which makes it pretty heavy. And with that snow packed in there, it gives you less volume, so you're gonna shovel less snow. But don't worry, I have a quick tip on how to prevent the snow from sticking to your shovel. Let me show you. First, you're gonna wanna dry the shovel so there's no snow or water on it. And the trick to keeping all that snow from sticking to the shovel is to grab something like a paste wax, and you could wax the entire shovel and let it sit for like 5 minutes. Or if you want, you could even use a spray wax or spray ceramic. In this case, I have a spray ceramic. And all you need to do, spray a bunch on, and you're gonna let it sit for 5 minutes. And then you can buff it off with a fresh microfiber towel, and now your shovel is waxed or ceramic coated. And as they say, the proof is in the pudding. So let's shovel up some snow, and as you can see, the snow slides right off. The hydrophobic wax or ceramic coating that you use will keep the surface slick so the snow doesn't stick. All right, so with the snow removed from the driveway, now let me show you how to safely remove the snow from your car. And the reason why I say safely is because most people use a brush like this to get the snow off their car. And a brush like this, these bristles will definitely scratch the finish on your car. Guaranteed, they're too stiff. Even the soft end on the brush, the squeegee end, could scratch your paint. So how do you prevent that? Use something soft like a microfiber towel and cover your brush. And now your brush could be used with less risk to scratching your paint. Now to hold this microfiber towel in place so it doesn't fall off, I like to use these binder clips and just clip that microfiber towel on the back of the brush. That way you don't have to worry about those clips damaging the paint. and now we can use our brush with a very soft microfiber towel so we don't scratch the paint. Now before you go and use a brush, even with the microfiber towel, it's better if you could remove the snow without actually touching the car. Let me show you. And you might be wondering, how do you remove snow without touching it? Well, using a leaf blower, electric or gas, these work awesome when the powder is fresh.
Check this out. This is another trick I wish I would have known sooner. Now the leaf blower definitely works better on fresh, powdery snow, and this snow is starting to freeze and get pretty heavy, yet it's still working pretty good. It gets all the snow off the truck and we're not touching the surface. Just make sure you don't hit the paint with the leaf blower. Otherwise, this is completely touchless and works great so you don't scratch your paint. But if you compare that to the fresh, powdery snow we had a couple of days ago, look at this, the leaf blower works amazing. It blows the snow off effortlessly and leaves a completely snow-free car. Using a leaf blower is such an amazing trick. Once you try it, you're not gonna wanna use any other method.
So when the snow is a fresh powder, it's not frozen on there, you didn't start the car, it's not melted at all, the leaf blower blows all that snow right off without touching the paint. It's really easy to do, and it actually leaves a pretty clean surface. And we blew off our garbage bags from the windshield, and check it out, the windshield is looking absolutely amazing. No ice, no snow, and it's ready to go.
The other benefit of a leaf blower over a brush is it gets snow out of the tough to remove spots. For example, the roof rack on my truck. Usually it's a pain to get all the snow out of here, but with the leaf blower, it blows it right out. And finally, the last part is to get the snow off the bed cover, and again, it blows it right off, even though it's pretty heavy now and starting to freeze.
Now for the Jag, I'm gonna show you how well the brush works with the microfiber towel. Maybe you don't have a leaf blower, or the snow is too heavy and icy. Well, this is what you're gonna use to remove the snow. The key is not to put any downward pressure onto the brush. We don't want to push it into the paint. Just let the weight of the brush slide along the paintwork. This will let the microfiber towel skim across the paint surface without scratching it, and you're going to get all the snow off your car like there's nothing to it. And finally, check this out. Once the snow is removed, the last thing to do is remove that windshield cover, and all the snow and ice comes with it, revealing a nice and clean windshield. And the last thing to do is remove the bags from the side view mirrors, and check this out. Once you remove this, it is ice-free and ready to go.
And I'll show you the truck as well, because check this out.
All the ice builds up on this instead of your side view mirror. Such a simple little trick saves you so much hassle.
Just compare that to this, which is covered in ice and snow. Luckily, that's actually coming off pretty easy, but if that gets frozen on there, that is a pain to remove,
just like this. You can see how it's frozen on there, and that is gonna have to defrost. Never use a scraper on your side view mirrors.
And speaking of scraper, a lot of brushes have these scrapers on the end. Never, ever, ever use these on paint. Do not do that. You will scratch and damage your paint pretty badly, even if there's ice on the top. Do not do it.
Only use it on the glass like this. Since glass is a lot harder than plastic, you don't have to worry about it scratching the glass with the plastic scraper.
So I repeat, only use the plastic scraper on glass, just like this.
Now, if you don't have one of these scrapers, maybe you're at work or school or something and everything's frozen over, in a pinch, you could use a credit card or a gift card like this. Make sure you grab the whole credit card and just use the edge, that way you don't damage it. And obviously be careful not to break the credit card, but look how well this works. In a pinch, if you need to remove some ice, just grab a credit card out of your wallet and you'll be good to go. And one last quick tip on frozen glass, whether it's your windshield or side glass, never, ever, ever use boiling water or very hot water and pour it directly onto your windshield or glass. It can crack it and that wouldn't be good. So just pour that out. And instead, what you're gonna do is grab a Ziploc bag and just fill it up with hot tap water, not boiling water, just hot tap water like this,
and slowly slide the warm bag against the glass, which is gonna melt away the ice. Just look at how awesome this works. You don't have to worry about the glass cracking. And that ice is being melted, revealing crystal clear glass that you could actually see out of. You could also use this method on the windshield, the side view mirrors, and your headlights if they're frozen.
So there you go, those are all my tips and tricks on how to get your car ready for a snowstorm and then easily clean off the car so you don't scratch it, you don't damage it, and you can get it done nice and quickly so you can get to school, get to work, wherever you need to go without being late. If you guys have any of your own tips to share, please comment them in the comments below. As always, I hope the video was helpful. If it was, remember to give it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber, consider hitting that subscribe button. And as always, all the tools and products I used in this video are linked in the description so you could easily find them. And make sure you guys stay safe out there.